Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Madam Shaza and I teach science for Form 1, Form 2 and Form 3 at Sekolah Menengah Sains Tuanku Menaweh. In today's lesson, we are going to learn about the substances that are harmful to our respiratory system as well as the diseases and their symptoms. In today's lesson, you should be able to communicate about the substances that are harmful to the respiratory system as well as diseases and their symptoms. The quality of air can have significant effects on our respiratory system. As air moves into our lungs, harmful substances in the air may enter too. These harmful substances can cause diseases or even death in the long term. Examples of such substances are as follow. The diagram shows harmful substances that may be found in cigarette smoke. Have you heard about nicotine before? Nicotine is produced by tobacco plants that are being used in cigarettes. Nicotine causes addiction to smoker. It also causes rapid heartbeat, increases blood pressure, and rapid breathing. In the long term, nicotine may cause emphysema and stroke. Tar can also be found in cigarette smoke. Please be aware that cigarette tar and tar used in making roads are different substances. Cigarette tar is normally labeled as TAR, which is the acronym for total aerosol residue. Cigarette tar in inhaled air sticks to our air passage. The tar then kills the cells in our air passage, such as the thorax, pharynx, epiglottis, larynx, bronchi, bronchioles, and alveoli. Cigarette tar also increases the production of mucus and phlegm in the lungs. It also irritates the respiratory tract, causing the smoker's cough. Most of the lung cancer patients are smokers. Cigarette tar is an example of a substance in the cigarette smoke that can cause lung cancer, emphysema, and bronchitis. Carbon monoxide is usually found in cigarette smoke too. They are colorless and odorless. Carbon monoxide can combine with hemoglobin faster than oxygen. Hence, when carbon monoxide diffuses from alveoli into the blood capillaries, it will combine chemically with hemoglobin to form a stable carboxyhemoglobin. This causes a shortage of oxygen in the red blood cells. The body cells are unable to produce the required amount of energy due to this shortage. This may cause dizziness, headaches, and fatigue. Sulfur dioxide that is released into the air is normally produced by the combustion of coal from the power stations. Sulfur dioxide is also a colorless gas but comes with a pungent smell. It irritates the respiratory tract, causing cough, difficulty in breathing, bronchitis, and lung cancer. Sulfur dioxide are also being used in food production sector as preservatives to prevent bacteria growth. It is usually used to preserve fruits after harvesting. Sulfur dioxide is widely used as preservatives, but there are limits that are being set for the amount allowed in food to protect the consumers. Too much of sulfur dioxide can cause an upset stomach. Nitrogen dioxide that is released into the air is normally produced by the combustion of fossil fuels such as petrol and diesel. Unlike sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide is a brown-colored gas but also comes with a pungent smell. Nitrogen dioxide irritates the air passage and the lung tissues. It causes cough, difficulty in breathing, and asthma. Haze, dust, and pollens are fine, solid particles that are suspended in the air. The smoke from motor vehicle exhaust, open burning and forest fires produce haze and dust. Meanwhile, pollen released from the anthers of the flowers are being carried away by the wind over long distances in all directions. Haze, dust, and pollen may irritate the respiratory system and cause cough, nasal congestion, watery nose, sneezing, and shortness of breath. It also may cause respiratory diseases such as asthma and bronchitis. Those harmful substances in the air that you have learned just now can cause diseases such as asthma, emphysema, bronchitis, and lung cancer. Asthma is a disease that is caused by the narrowing of the fine airways in the bronchi and bronchioles due to the contraction of muscles in their walls. This might be triggered by the presence of dust, pollen, haze, cigarette smoke, and motor vehicle exhaust. An asthma patient will find it difficult to breathe, experience wheezing, coughing, and feel tightness in the chest. Bronchitis is a disease that is caused by the inflammation of the lining of the bronchioles. This may be due to infection by bacteria or viruses or chemicals such as those found in cigarette smoke. Chronic bronchitis is a condition characterized by recurrent or chronic cough every day over a period of several months. The smoker's cough is an early sign of chronic bronchitis. In severe cases, the patient's fingers and lips may turn blue due to poor oxygenation of blood. Emphysema is the condition of the alveoli in the lungs which are being damaged by harmful substances in the air, such as the irritants in the cigarette smoke. This reduces the surface area for gas exchange. The patient cannot take in enough oxygen and has very short breath. Other symptoms of emphysema include pain when breathing and feeling tired from doing even a light task. There is no cure for emphysema, but the symptoms of this disease can be controlled. And lastly, the lung cancer. Lung cancer is a disease that is caused by a change in the cells inside the lungs that divide out of control and produce lumps of cells known as tumors, which interfere with the normal functions of the lungs. This disease occurs due to chemicals in the cigarette smoke, such as tar, which contain cancer-causing substances known as carcinogens. These chemicals are being inhaled during breathing. Symptoms of lung cancer include persistent coughing, blood in the phlegm, and feeling pain when breathing. Lung cancer may not have any symptoms. When it is detected, the cancer cells may have spread from the lungs to the other organs. As a conclusion, smoking is dangerous to human health. However, the number of smokers keeps increasing in Malaysia, especially among teenagers. Cigarette smoke contains thousands of toxic chemicals that affects the respiratory system of the smokers as well as the passive smokers. Smoking is not only harmful to the respiratory system of smokers, but also to the respiratory system of other people in the vicinity of the smokers. A person who does not smoke but inhales cigarette smoke is known as the passive smoker. The harmful effects of the cigarette smoke to the human respiratory system do not only happen to the body of the smoker, but also in the body of the passive smoker. The risk of getting diseases in the passive smokers is the same as the smokers. Cigarette is harmful regardless of what type it is. Say no to smoking.
Thank you for watching. See you again in our next lesson.